Kosten.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live at another restaurant with more great food, with more great things to talk about. And this time we're at a brand new restaurant. We're at Tacos and Tequila. And guys, it's restaurant week. We are one day away. Restaurant week starts tomorrow. It's presented by Mercedes-Benz of Bonita Springs. Also the Greg Norman Collection at Miramar Outlets. And guys, we're dining with purpose. We're dining with a cause. $1 from every meal goes to our Sizzle Southwest Florida Food and Beverage Scholarship. Guys, we have awesome food. We have 71 of the best restaurants in all of Southwest Florida participating. We have restaurants from Marco Island to Naples to Bonita, Estero, where we're at right now, Fort Myers, and Cape Coral. Guys, if you check Restaurant Week, sizzlerestaurantweek.com, it's going to give you a list of all the restaurants, all the menus, all the great food. You're going to learn a little bit more about our scholarship and even our sponsors. Like I said, we're here at Tacos Tequila in Estero, Florida. We have a brand new restaurant. This is actually their brand new location at University Village. One of awesome restaurants. They actually have three locations. They have one on Davis. They have another one at Vanderbilt. And they have this one, which is here in University Village. Guys, restaurant week, one day away. Make your reservations, visit our website. And right here on the table, we're going to look at some of the items on their three-course menu that starts at $26 here. They even have some drinks. They have some margaritas. They even have a flight of tequila. And we're sitting down with Chef Adam. How are you, man?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Listen, this is probably my favorite one that we're doing because we're doing tequila and margaritas, and it's not even noon.
Who doesn't like that?
No, it's not even
noon. It's never too early to start drinking tequila.
Well, Adam, listen. So this is, you guys are new. Miss Kelly. We love Kelly.
Yeah.
Owner, operator of the Tacos Tequilas. But tell us about yourself and you.
I helped start open the first location down at Davis. I'm a local, born and raised in Naples.
Cool.
Went to culinary school in Miami, then came back and worked at many different types of restaurants, higher end steakhouses, Italian restaurants. But this has always been my favorite cuisine. You know, you can't go wrong with tacos and tequila.
way to throw that ad in there. We had no way to go wrong with tacos and tequila. I mean, dude, high end steakhouses, culinary school, and now we're out here making, I call it gourmet artisan tacos. What do you call it?
I call it taco fusion.
Taco fusion.
Yeah.
I like that.
It's kind of that Tex-Mex kind of, but any, you can pretty much use tortillas as a vessel for anything.
Beautiful.
You know, I do anything from fried shrimp tacos with sriracha mayonnaise to grilled chicken, carne asada.
Fried shrimp tacos with sriracha mayonnaise.
Yeah. And then
dude, that sounds like money.
Oh, I got it. You haven't tried my new one yet. Korean beef taco with kimchi.
Dude, kimchi. Listen, yeah. After as soon as the video is over, I'm ordering that 100%. I'm half Filipino.
Yeah.
So kimchi, I'm like, oh yeah, bring that on.
Yeah.
Bring that on. Well, for those that don't know, I mean, this is traditional. You guys do traditional tacos, but for those that have never been at Tacos Tequila, what can someone expect from your menu?
They can expect to find something that they're going to like. How we develop this menu is to be, it's kind of like how we develop the restaurant. It's very comfortable. It's very inviting. You will find something that you're going to like on this menu. If it's either, you know, our traditionals like a carne asada taco, or if you're not as adventurous, we have a cheeseburger taco that we put queso blanco on, pickles, lettuce, tomatoes. You know, you're going to find something that you're going to like on this menu.
Which I've had, and it's money.
Yeah.
Like, it's money. Now, also, you guys have vegan, vegetarian tacos.
Yep. I've started breaking into now different tofu marinated tacos. And then we have a roasted vegetable medley that we do, and we can do it with burritos and enchiladas, quesadillas. So even vegetarians and vegans, we have menu options.
So now for vegans, because we do have, we kind of always ask, you know, I know you guys have vegetarian options,
right,
for restaurant week.
Right.
Do you have vegan options?
So our tofu, how it's marinated, it is vegan. And then when we cook, you cook with usually either like an olive oil or a soybean oil.
Yeah.
So that we can make it vegan friendly.
Oh, so
all three items. So all three courses. There's something that can be vegan for everyone.
We can do, because what we do for the tacos, that we can, you can do like a mix and match of different ones, so we can have a vegan option with our different tacos.
Awesome. And the reason, I mean, we ask this all the time, and you've been a chef for a while, and you from Miami all the way up here, we see that the vegan vegetarian community is growing. It's on the rise. And
yes.
Do you see that down there too?
You see that? I did see that down there, and we see that up here now. And you know, that's another reason why we recently just started putting tofu products on the menu. You know, we have to adapt, and it's a growing trend. And I actually like tofu.
Yeah.
You know, I wouldn't eat just tofu because that would limit, you know, what I eat because I love everything, but...
Yeah, I couldn't just eat tofu because that would change my whole job atmosphere.
Exactly.
And but no, I understand and I get it. Well, Chef, listen, it's Restaurant Week's one day away, guys. Restaurant Week, May 31st to June 13th. Make your reservations. Visit our website, sizzlerestaurantweek.com. It's the first day. I'm at Tacos Tequila. I'm looking at your Restaurant Week menu. Where do we start?
All right, let's start with an appetizer.
Okay.
How you comfortable with like a Mexican street kind of fare? You know,
you gotta
have your elotes
all day. And this is classic.
This is classic elotes. Little chili aioli mixed with little cotija, roasted corn. Can't go wrong with that. Eat it right on the cob. We leave the husk on there.
Dude, that's awesome, guys. Look at this. What is this called? One more time, chef.
It's an elote.
Elote. Look, and what's on that again?
That's cotija, and then it's a chili aioli.
Now, does every order come with two?
Yes, every order comes with two.
Gosh, delicious looking. That's a great size for your first course.
Absolutely.
You guys are not cheaping out, so yeah. I want to give a special shout out to Kelly over there for making sure you guys really did it up. What will be the next thing we look at?
All right, these over here, these are potato taquitos. So another
potato taquitos.
So that another vegetarian option. And then they're a deep fried, almost taquito means little taco. So they're deep fried and then topped with our house made guacamole. Our guacamole we make in house, fresh every day with fresh Hass avocados.
Yeah, you keep talking.
And then just a little bit of sour cream on that. And then the next one that we have is our chili rellenos. And then this is kind of our version of it. There's a traditional way of
chili rellenos. Where are we at?
We're over here. So we're a little unconditional when it comes to this version of it. So there are jalapenos that they're done in our Modelo Negro beer batter. So they're deep fried. And then we make do a chipotle crema sauce, a little cotija cheese, and a little bit of cilantro. And then we'd have a little dipping in a cilantro lime ranch.
Cilantro lime ranch. Now, out of your three appetizers, is everything on your menu? These are all classics, right? These
yeah.
are things that you guys have all the time.
Yes.
Now, which ones sell the most?
The elotes, for
By
sure.
By far?
For sure, the elotes sell the most. We go through at least a case of corn a day.
Gosh.
In the off-season.
In the off-season. Oh, well, here's a good question. Now, you guys are brand new.
Yeah.
This is a brand new location. You're at University Village, which is, I mean, like a hop skip away from FGCU. How's everything been over here?
It's closer than a hop skipping away. I can hit a dorm with a football from here.
If you can throw it 150 yards. All right, that's cool. So how's it been going over here? How's the new restaurant been?
It's going great. A lot of good feedback.
It's
a lot
almost
of,
like, what, 2 weeks old?
Yeah. This is the second week, yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And it's going great. A lot of good feedback, a lot of good customers. And, you know, right now school's not in session, and we're staying busy. And
yeah,
we're actually,
awesome.
It's not just students, too. You know, we're getting a lot of the local people that have families and stuff, you know.
I mean, where else are you going to get tacos in Estero? I mean, you're not going to get in Gulf Coast Town Center.
No.
You're not going to get other places. Guys, this is a great opportunity. Go out, visit restaurants. Restaurant Week, it starts tomorrow. You want to make your reservations. We're going to look at some of the food that's here on the table. Guys, we have 71 of the best restaurants in all of Southwest Florida. And a big thank you, to our great sponsors, Mercedes-Benz of Bonita Springs and also the Greg Norman Collection. Adam, we just went through some of your appetizers. Tell us what we're eating for entrees.
Okay, so part of our Restaurant Week menu, you can do a flight of three tacos, and I just picked a couple of...
A flight of three tacos.
We also have a flight of tequila, too.
Yes,
so.
And we are going to get to that. And There's a margarita here. I'm going to start sipping on, by the way.
Yeah, we'll do the flights of tequila off camera.
Off camera, off camera. Kelly doesn't have to get mad about that.
Exactly.
Okay, so you have, which tacos do you have here specifically?
This one I just kind of did a little bit of variety. So this is a carne asada taco, very traditional grilled steak with our house-made grill seasoning, a lot of flavor. And just on the traditional way, a little cotija cheese, cilantro, onions, and radishes. And then this one is a little bit more of when we talk about our fusion. So this is one that I was talking about before. This is fried shrimp, and we do it in case we do it in like a cornmeal and a cornflour mixture.
Okay.
So even say if you were gluten free,
I got it.
Still have that on a corn tortilla. Beautiful. So, you know, it doesn't limit it. You know, our menu, it doesn't limit it to also people who are gluten-free or celiac. You know, that's another one of the trends that are growing right now. So even if you're celiac, you can still come in here and find things that you can have. And, you know, we know that that's a growing thing, and we're willing to work with people and help people with, that have certain allergies like that.
And that's the reason, I mean, that's also the reason why, going back, you know, we've said that Tacos Tequila brand has been so successful.
Yeah.
Because you're not just even for being Mexican food,
yeah,
you guys are well-rounded.
Taco fusion.
You know, you guys are well-rounded. You offer vegan stuff, vegetarian stuff, yeah, gluten-free stuff. And that must bring in a whole ton of people support.
It definitely does. You know, because a lot of people are afraid to go out because of that. Because they're afraid they're not going to find something that they're going to like. So that's why I said, you know, you have options, and if you have dietary restriction, or even if you're a vegetarian or vegan, you know, we can accommodate you here.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, so this is our fried shrimp with a sriracha mayo.
Here we go.
And then it gets fresh jalapenos, green onions, and then diced red bell peppers. And then this one over here, this is our California taco. So it's seasoned grilled chicken. And then it gets a little bit of cheese, jack cheese, lettuce, guacamole, bacon, of course.
Of course.
You gotta throw bacon on a couple of things.
Yes, you're right.
And then a little of our cilantro lime ranch, our famous cilantro lime ranch.
Famous cilantro lime ranch. Why is it famous? Because everyone loves it?
People will put it on everything.
Yeah, I hear that.
Yeah.
Listen, that sriracha mayo sounds like something I put on everything, me personally. All right, so we got the flight of tacos, went through some appetizers. I know this is next. You can't lie to me.
Yeah, that's one of our burritos. And our burritos we can do with a lot of different fillings. You know, we have our like traditional ground beef, like chipotle chicken, carne asada, carnitas. You know, we have a lot of protein. Or if you want to go vegetarian, you can do our mixed veggies, or you could do tofu inside of it also.
Awesome. Now, what does this one have in the middle?
This one is a bean and rice one.
Oh, a bean and rice one.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Awesome. And you said there's other choices you can get, other proteins you can get with this?
Yes,
what are the other proteins?
Like I said, carne asada, which is our grilled steak. Also, we could do pollo, which is our pulled chicken. Some people do shrimp, too. We have tequila lime marinated shrimp.
Can you do tofu?
Of course you can do tofu.
Man, I couldn't imagine. I mean, a whole burrito full of tofu might sound good, but I'm all about that carne asada.
Exactly. Or carnitas. Pulled pork.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm trying to think. Which one's the red shredded beef?
El Pastor?
Yeah.
Yes.
That's where it's at.
Which we have that on the menu, too.
That's where it's at for me.
Pineapples?
Yeah. Yeah. Pineapples go in your tacos, but they do, or your burritos, but they don't go on pizza. Don't at me. I know Guy and like some other people, Dagan and some guys, we've had these social media arguments. If pineapples go on pizza, does it go on pizza?
Doesn't go on pizza.
It does not go on pizza. All right, perfect. That's it. You're my favorite guy right now. What else do we got?
We're going to finish off with dessert right now. Real traditional. Can't go wrong with churros.
Oh, yeah.
And then we do an espresso dipping sauce.
An espresso dipping sauce.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So, which we use Abuelita, which is like a Mexican chocolate that you would use for doing like hot chocolate. So it has a really unique taste to that. And then just your cinnamon sugar fried to perfection.
Dude, I love it. Cinnamon sugar fried to perfection. Chef Adam, I want to thank you guys so much. Guys, it's restaurant week. We're at Tacos Tequila, University Village. That is right 150 yards. We're literally looking at the FGCU
door. I can hit it with a football.
He can hit it with a football. I can hit it with a driver. I mean, I can hit it with a golf club. Guys, restaurant week. We are one day away. Make your reservations. SizzleRestaurantWeek.com. We are at Tacos and Tequila in Estero, Florida. We have other great cities that we're in, as well as Marco Island, Naples, Fort Myers, Estero, Bonita, Cape Coral. I know I wasn't in order, but you guys know the map. You guys know all the cities. Join us for 71 of the best restaurants in Southwest Florida. My name is Rafael Feliciano with Silo Restaurant Week, and I'm getting off here so I can drink my margarita off camera.
I got the shots already poured.